I put my heart in this. Why does everyone think they're the hardest? Why do you speak for the sake of speaking? You don't even know what you're trying to describe. Honey, calm down, calm down. I was just trying to be nice. If that's how it's gonna be, your future might be really bleak. It's your own fault that you feel your feelings. I'm not responsible for your losses. I'm not responsible for your problems. I was around back then, but I'm not around right now. Find someone else who will care. Find someone else who will help you while I'm on my business. I do what I want, no diddy. Who's gonna stop me, no diddy? You ain't that great to be silly. You're another facade, no diddy. I do what I want, no diddy. Who's gonna stop me, no diddy?
Nah, fuck that, nigga. We gonna start right there, nigga. Let's start there because today might be the last day we can talk about it. The Yankees right now, if you remember the prediction I made, is complete fucking opposite of what's going on right now. The Yankees are getting their ass whipped. Completely whipped.
Outplayed. Outhit.
Outmatched.
Defense, coaching, especially coach.
Bro. It looks bad, bro. This would never have happened if Derek Jeter was here.
Yeah, and you know what? Because Jeter is doing like the commentary with A-Rod and Big Poppy.
Yeah.
So yo, like fucking Yas can see like up in Jeter's face. He's disgusted, bro.
And I'll be honest with you, I'm always asked about my career. People say, was there something you could change? And I don't think I've ever said this before. There's nothing I would change about my career except being able to play in a Yankees Dodgers World Series.
Oh, wow. Bridge!
I love that.
He's disgusted. I'm telling you, man. Like, it's crazy because, you know, like fucking Yas play like the whole year. And you bust ass the whole year to get to this point. And you throw up a fucking offer, a donut, sweat. And, like, you know, and as people may know, I am a Mets fan. But I'm a baseball fan too, you know what I'm saying? So it's like it's crazy seeing like the Yankees play like the way that they playing, bro. They got no heart, they got no vibe, they got no type of energy, nothing. They putting up no fight, bro. And as a person who's born and raised in the Bronx, it's just like, oh. It's not it, champ. It's not it.
Look, man. I be like locked in with the editing and shit. Like I be trying to get all of these shows out and everything. So first thing in the morning after a fucking World Series game as a Yankee fan, the last thing you want to do is go on fucking Jay Storm's fucking page, bro. Don't look at the nigga stories. Because, like, this is my man's, and as a New Yorker, you don't want to see certain shit, especially from your man's. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you would swear this nigga, like, oh, my God, bro. Like, I was a baseball fan. I'm a Yankee fan. I got them tatted on my back. And, yes, I'm hurting because other than the fucking Liberty, the fucking New York teams can't fucking catch a break, man.
Yo, bro. Yesterday, the Giants lost. The Knicks lost. And the Yankees lost. All on the same day.
Did the Jets? The Jets lost.
Luke? I think the Jets played this upcoming Thursday.
Oh, they had a bye week, so they lost on the bye week. So yeah, they lost. Yeah. They lost.
I mean,
it's sad, man. It's a sad day in New York. I mean, and we got the Liberty though,
and New York is supposed to be like a sports town. You know what I'm saying? Which, you know, of course it is. You know, we have tons of teams. You know what I'm saying? And but I live right now up in PA, right? And I could say that this is a sports town here. Because they die hard.
Oh, yeah.
Okay?
PA, Cleveland.
It's real. Like, sports is life over here. You know what I mean? But,
I'm bro, so disappointed.
Like, the Yankees have had, like, their chances up in this series, man. You know, in game two, the Yankees had the bases. Well, first of all, let's go back to game one.
Exactly.
Okay? When they took out Gerrit Cole after he just threw only 88 pitches, man. This is the World Series. It's do or die. It's for all the marbles. It's for the chip. And you're going to take them out? Bro, I'm rocking.
A lot of these niggas
is on fall off, bro.
Yeah, a lot of these niggas
is no tomorrow.
It's a different professional league, man. Because a lot of these people that are on these big stages, like the quarterback that decided to take himself out because he said he was tired.
Man, tired. I ain't gonna lie. That was a lot of running right there that I did, and I don't think I was gonna be able to go that next play. So I just you know, just whole saying I just needed a break right there.
It's just like these dudes is I remember motherfucking you had an opener that lasted 6-7 innings, then right. You had seven, eight.
Right.
And then you had a closer, a strong closer that came at the at like 8-9.
Yeah, but now the game is played differently now, you know what I'm saying? So I get it, but still, that's your ace. That's your cream of the crop there, bro.
It's the only thing you do. That's your only job.
And that's your paying only them, job. And you paying them what, $250 million as a pitcher, bro? Yo, put his ass out there, man. He's good.
Niggas gotta show me more.
No,
I need more athletes.
And like, what happens? The Yankees, they took them out. They put like the relief pitchers, and they lose the game with a walk-off grand slam. Lose that game. That's crazy.
This game two.
The Yankees had the bases loaded. One out. Okay. I've been taught like since fucking Little League, bro. Just make contact. You don't have to hit a home run, bro. Just make contact. Just put the bat on the ball. You know, and like the young kid, like from the Yankees, who's supposed to be like the next Jeter.
One, you should have been in school instead of being in that parade. but right now, just think about it, man. You're a few wins away. Keep it going. You got a lot of kids now in the New York, New Jersey area that want to grow up and be you. So congratulations, man.
Thank you.
When Knoblauch was injured in particular, deep left field. Was open the first pitch, way back left field. Derek Jeter.
He's the super prospect supposed to be the next Jeter. Bases loaded. One out. Just make contact, brother. This is your time to shine. This is the time where you go from being the rookie and the super prospect onto a star. This was your shot. This was your shot. Strikeout, bro. Come on,
Jeter would never.
Come on, bro. Just put the ball in play. I mean, and he's swinging for pitches way outside of the strike zone. Like, bro. I don't see the fight. With the Yankees, man.
This is a young team, right? This is like a bunch of young cats that made it to the series, or
it's a mixture, but it's a lot of young players, like in their 20s in there. You know what I'm saying? But you're the Yankees. You're the Yankees.
Right. This right here has destroyed my childhood, because when the Yankees used to go to the World Series, it used to just be like, yo, bro, either, you know, it's going to happen. And right now, I feel like I'm hurt, man. I'm hurt. I watched the Grand Slam. And when I watched the Grand Slam, I'm not going to lie, bro, I really wanted to cry. I wanted to cry just for many reasons, just because it was like, yo, like, This is the Yankees. This is the World Series. This is our time. Like, I'm not familiar with baseball as I should be. Like, I was the dude that was like, oh, the Yankees is back. Oh, let's go. Like, but this is not the way I wanted it to end. And it's over. If you come back from a 3-0, bro.
Only one team in the history of baseball, one team has ever come back down 0-3.
Wasn't that Boston?
The 2004 Boston Red Sox. Boston. Against who?
The Yankees.
The Yankees.
I remember that game. I was actually going for Boston because I was so tired of being a Yankee fan. I wanted something different.
And this team from the Yankees, they're just not the same. Not the same.
No.
So, because actually for the game yesterday, which was the game 3, Yankees are down for like most of the game. But then I think in the 8th or like 9th inning, like this kid, he hits a home run. So I'm like, okay, all right.
We back here.
Bro, like the guy hit the home run and there was no enthusiasm.
Right.
Up in the dugout. There was no smiling or clapping or high fives or nothing. It's like they gave up already. They have given up already.
Right. I mean, I don't want to give up, but a 3-0 is four games in a row that you have to win. You got to dig deep.
Against the Dodgers.
And honestly, I'll keep it real with you. I think that I would expect the Dodgers to just end it real quick. But I feel like since they're in the Bronx tonight, they might just play with their food, bro. Bring it back home. Let's end this home.
And did you see all the LA fans up in the stadium?
So disrespectful. That's like Snoop came and crushed the towers all over again, bro. In the Bronx? And nobody got punched? It's crazy.
I mean, I'm sure.
It's crazy, bro.
It's not like if we're going to hear it in the news, but...
Bro, I'm...
...lead that Betts is getting. It's huge. Freeman cracks one deep to right field and gone again. Freddie Freeman floating in the World Series. Another 0-2, Verdugo. Grounds one to first. Freeman's got it. Takes it to the bag. They do get Volpe home. That's a run they absolutely had to have. Kid, bases loaded, two out. Cranks a ball. Deep left field. Volpe with redemption. Smith sends a fly ball the other way. Back goes Soto. That short porch. It's got a chance and it's gone. On an 0-2 pitch, Will Smith lofts a fly ball the other way to make it 5-3. Yankees fans are wishing they had in game one. Tim Hilligan's Freddie Freeman. 4-6. Close play in time.
After review, the call on the field is overturned. The runner is safe. Los Angeles has two remaining challenges.
And so it's a one-run game as Max pitching in the World Series. Wells turns on a ball, sends it a mile. It's gone. Marathon, Honeywell, deals, Verdugo on the ground to second. Coming home is Lux, not in time. Driven the other way, deep right center field. It's got a chance and goodbye. This season, at least another day. Judge hooks a line drive to left field, and that's in for a hit. Soto and Judge both get on the board here in the eighth. It's 11 runs. His home run streak tomorrow. Into center field. Judge comes on. He's got it. And we've got a game five in the Bronx tomorrow night.
Chance to come up with a big hit here. On a 2-1. Pops it up. Shallow left. Not going to do it. Infield fly rule in effect, and Edmonds got out number two. Doesn't it seem like it continues to fall on Anthony Volpe?
Well, this is a great opportunity for him. It seriously is. I mean, we'll never know if it costs the team a run or not, but you don't think he's thinking about gap, clearing the bases right here?
New York kid, bases loaded, two out. Cranks a ball, deep left field.